Welcome to this episode of Colecandoo. In this episode, we're going to show you how to align variable data images that use the Fit Frames to Images option. Typically, they will only align to the top left of any image, but in this case, we're going to show you how to align them, in this case, to, say, the bottom right, which is something that you can't normally do. So as we scroll through the records here, you can see that that's happening. So I've got a sample file here that's just got some dummy text and it has my placeholder for the variable images. Now, I don't have any variable images at the moment, but if I want to get them very quickly from a folder, there's a good script from Zalto, which is run by Loic Agen, and it's called Images to CSV. This, I think, may be a separate version, but have a look at his website. The link's in the description below. So I'm just going to load that. Okay, so that's made our links for us. So it just puts the name of the image and also what the image is. I'm just going to drag that there. And with my content placement options, I want the frames to actually fit the images. So the images are going to make the size. But here's my problem. I actually want the image to line up to this corner. I don't want it to line up to this corner. So if we just move the image over here, that's fine for this record. We go to the next record, you can see that it's not lining up again. You can see it isn't lining up. So, let's go to another record. Okay, you get the idea of what's going on. So this is just how InDesign's data merge behaves. It always lines up to the top left. It doesn't matter if you have center image in frame. That makes no difference. All that will do, if I change my content placement options to something a bit different, such as fit images proportionally, for example, and then have center in frame, I'll just adjust the size of this so you can see it happen, then it centers it within the frame itself, but it doesn't actually center the frame in the space on the page. It always lines up to the top left. So I'll just put those options back. I want fit frame to images and centering frame. So how do we get our variable image to line up to the top right hand corner? Well, we cheat, that's what we do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a text box. It's going to be a very large text box. Okay, turn my preview off for this trick. So I made a text box, then I'm going to cut this. Go back to my text tool, and I'm going to paste this in as an inline graphic. What I can then do is I can then right align this. You'll see that I've done that here. And now it right aligns. But every so often I will get an image that is bigger than this text box. And when it does that, the image is going to overset and go missing. So how do you get rid of that? The answer is you go into your text frame options and you go auto size and you go auto size height and width and you tell it where you want it to get its size from. In this case, it's going to be the top right hand corner. So preview, go okay. So now we can cycle through every record here. Now, let's say we wanted to line it up to the bottom. Just going to put a guideline here. First thing I'm going to do is turn my preview off. Just go back to my text frame options, auto size. I'm going to change that to the bottom right. And what I can also do is add an insurance, is align that to the bottom of the frame. Okay, I'm gonna move the image down. Sorry, well, you have to be very careful when you're grabbing this too. You wanna make sure you're only grabbing the text, not the image inside. So now we go through our preview. There we go. So that's a technique that I hope you'll be able to use going forward with Adobe InDesign. That's it for the video. You can get in touch with me via Twitter at Colecandoo, check out the blog colecandoo.com, and see my articles at indesignsecrets.com, as well as all of the usual terrific content. Till we meet again, I'll see you later.